Hello everyone, welcome back to Ilium Biology. Let's start with today's mnemonics. Today we are dealing with some mnemonics from the Animal Kingdom chapter. We would be learning about the examples from different kingdoms and different groups of animals that are frequently asked in examinations. So the first mnemonic is to learn the examples of ostrichthyes, that is the bony fishes. Ostrichthyes is that class of fish which includes all bony fishes. See, a bone is made up of calcium. So in order to make our bones stronger, what we take calcium tablets. So in case you want to remember the examples of bony fish, just remember to take calcium tablets, and the company that you should take is Hema calcium tablets. So let's start with the mnemonic. The mnemonic is Hema calcium tablets. Now these tablets would remind us about strong bones. So the mnemonic belongs to the bony fishes. Now Hema, the first alphabet of Hema is H, which means hippocampus, that is seahorse. This is the picture of a seahorse. Next is E. E would remind you about Exocetus or the flying fish. And next is MA, Hema's MA, which means marine. That means these two examples, hippocampus and Exocetus, belong to marine bony fish. In NCERT, in the examples of bony fish, they have classified into three groups: marine fishes, freshwater fishes, and fishes used in aquarium. So we are learning the examples as per the different groups. So the first group is marine fishes. We can learn the examples by the word Hema, that is hippocampus, Exocetus, and marine. Next is calcium. Now CA of calcium would remind us about Katla, or in English we call it as Katla. See, the one written in italics, the words written in italics are the scientific names, and the names written in non-italics are the normal common names of those organisms. So CA would remind us about Katla. Next is L. L would help us to remember Labio, that is Rohu. Rohu is again the common name, Labio is the zoological name. Next is C. C is for Clarias or Magur. So Katla, Labio, and Clarias, these all belong to freshwater fishes. The first word is Hema, which helps you to remember marine fishes, that is Exocetus and Hippocampus. The next, calcium, would help us to remember freshwater fishes, that is Katla, Labio, and Clarias. Next is tablet. Now this tablet would help us to remember the examples of fishes used in aquarium. First is T. T would help us to remember pterophyllum. Pterophyllum starts with P though, but P is silent, so we pronounce it as pterophyllum. So T for pterophyllum, that is angel fish. Next is A. A would help us to remember about aquarium, that is these examples are of aquarium fishes. And next is betta or fighting fish. So betta and pterophyllum are two fishes used in aquarium. Katla, Labio, Clarias are freshwater bony fishes, and hippocampus and exocetus are marine bony fishes. So that's how you can remember the examples of ostrichthyes. Now the next mnemonic, by this mnemonic we can remember all the examples of reptiles that are given in NCERT. I'm not leaving any example from NCERT, nor I'm adding any other example from any other book. We are strictly doing this as per the NCERT book. Now to remember the examples of reptiles, we first need to learn the concept of C4 cycle. Now C4 cycle, what is the biggest advantage of C4 cycle? That C4 cycle helps us to conserve water and also at the same time fixing carbon dioxide at a better efficiency rate than C3 plants. So the plants are thanking C4 cycle for the water conservation. So the mnemonic is, we are thanking C4 cycle. We are thanking C4 cycle. Why we are thanking C4 cycle? Because C4 cycle has helped us to conserve water. So the first is V. V would mean Vipera, that is viper snake. R means reptiles, that is this mnemonic is for the example of reptiles. Next is T. T reminds us of Testudo, that is tortoise. Next is H. H is for Hemi Ductilus, that is wall lizard. The lizard that you frequently see in your homes at your walls is the Hemiductilus or the wall lizard. Next is A. A would help us to remember alligator. You all must have seen alligators. Next is N. N is Naja. We all know about Naja. This is cobra snake. which is very poisonous. Next is crate. Crate is bungaros, another snake. Here you need to remember that Vipera, Naja and crate, all these snakes are poisonous snakes, and this is given in NCERT. Now ing of thinking would mean nothing here. So by thinking you can remember T for testudo, H for hemidactylus, A for alligator, N for Naja and K for crate or bungaros. Next is C4, that is four C's. Now the next four examples, all of them start with C. First C is chelon or turtles. Next C is crocodilus, that is crocodile. Next C is calotes or garden lizard. And the next C is chameleon or tree lizard. Here I'll tell you again, Vipera, Naja and crate are poisonous snakes. And C4 are four C's: chelon, crocodilus, calotes and chameleon. All these are examples of reptiles. So to remember the examples of reptiles, just think C4 cycle, that is we are thinking C4 cycle: Vipera, reptiles, testudo, hemidactylus, alligator, Naja, crate, chelon, crocodilus, calotes and chameleon. Here I am telling you one thing again, that all the words that are written in italics belong to the scientific names, are the scientific names basically, and the rest are the common names of those organisms. Now by the next mnemonic we would remember the examples of oscillomates and pseudoscillomates. This is a very frequently asked direct question in NEET, that which phylum has oscillomate, which phylum has pseudoscillom. So direct question, and there is a direct answer. There is just a single example, but we frequently get confused among those examples. So whenever such question of psyllium is asked in exam, just close your eyes and remember your father, and your father would help us to remember all those examples. How? See, father in Tamil is called as appa is basically a Tamil word which means father. So your appa, your father, would help you to remember the examples of oscillomates and pseudoscillomates. How? Let's see that. The first is A, that means oscillomate. Next is P, that is platyhelminthes or flatworms. Commonly platyhelminthes is the name of the phylum, and all the flatworms belong to platyhelminthes phylum. So platyhelminthes is oscillomate. Platyhelminthes, the entire organisms, all the organisms in platyhelminthes are oscillomates, that is they don't have psyllium. Now next P would mean pseudoscillomates, that is a false psyllium is present, and the example is aeschylomates, that is roundworms. So from henceforth it is very clear that platyhelminthes is oscillomate and aeschylomates is pseudoscillomate. And whom helped you to remember this? Your father or your appa helped you to remember all these examples. Now if we talk about the concept, all the phylums that are primitive to platyhelminthes, that is sponges, cnidarians and ctenophora, we never discuss about psyllium in those phylums. But the first phylum that we talk about psyllium is platyhelminthes, that is they don't have psyllium. Next phylum is aeschylomates, which has got a false psyllium, and all the phyla that are advanced to aeschylomates would have a true psyllium. Rather it be mollusca or echinodermata, chordata, hemichordata, all those have a true psyllium. So this is very clear now, that which organisms has got no psyllium, which organisms has got a false psyllium, and which phylum has got a true psyllium. But still, if you want a mnemonic to remember the examples of all psyllomates, then I would give you another mnemonic to remember the examples of all the phyla that are having a true psyllium. Now, which are the most advanced organisms against oscillomates, pseudoscillomates and coelomates? So we would go for coelomates. Yes, coelomates are the most advanced animals. So we would say that coelomates are champ. Coelomates are champ because they are most advanced. Now, by this line that coelomates are champ, you can remember all the phyla that are having a true coelom. The first word is coelomates. That would help us to remember that coelomates. This mnemonic is for the coelomates. Now R, first two alphabets is AR, by which you can remember arthropods. Arthropods starts with AR, so arthropods. Next is E, that means echinodermata, that means arthropoda and echinodermata are coelomates. Next is CHAMP, C would remember, help us to remember chordata. H would remind us hemichordata. A reminds us of annelids. M reminds us of mollusca. P would mean nothing here. So arthropods, echinodermata, chordates, hemichordates, annelids and mollusks all are true coelomates. All are having a true coelom. So that's it. Thank you very much for watching us. There are two more videos of animal kingdom examples. You should also watch them. Thank you very much for watching us. Stay connected with us for more such mnemonics and more such informative lectures in biology. Thank you very much for watching us.